a jam. and a longing in your heart. Will you be ashamed
to feel the pain.
Well, guys, thank you very much for being here and participating in this. Oh, fucking hell, look at that. Wow, God, that was amazing. Thanks for being part of this. How was that performance for you guys? How did you feel, like, kind of playing in the round and seeing each other in that sense, you think?
I just woke up.
I didn't really see anyone. Yeah. No, it was fun. It's kind of how we practice, so that was nice, yeah. Not to sound narcissistic, but I think that our enjoyment is kind of the top priority. You know what I mean? And then I think that inevitably provides a better performance for the audience, you know? So to me, it's like if I'm in the zone where it's like, let's play this song for 10 minutes or something, then that's what I'm gonna do, you know? And then I think that cool things come from that.
There's such a space and sparseness in the sound and stuff. Is that kind of like a really sort of, you know, like, you know, sort of thing that you go into when you're doing it, that it has to be that as the prerequisite, so you can have that room to maneuver?
It wasn't difficult or a stretch to make music that sounds more like this. It's just kind of a natural extension,
absolutely,
I think, of the tastes represented.
I rebuild from time to time to mark the day. I was with you then, without a doubt, or maybe just without. I don't wanna live again, 'cause I don't want this life to end. I don't wanna live again, 'cause it's just carried on. It's just carried. It's just carried on the way.
Started listening to Neil Young, etc. It was just like there were like 30 records that I could, you know, I love that. I love discovering somebody. Yeah, I love discovering somebody and then being like, there are all these records that, you know, that I can, you know, and you kind of decipher the different phases. I feel like music that takes risks, I mean, which I think is, whether I've been successful in doing that or not, it has always been my main value musically. And sometimes it works and sometimes it doesn't, but I feel like artists that do that tend to get to stick around a little longer, you know, as opposed to like debut album, second album, which is like kind of just an improvement on the first album, third album, take some risks, nobody likes it, end of career, you know, which is like this indie rock trajectory that is incredibly depressing to me.
Yeah.
But I like that it's the fifth record and a lot of people are just kind of hearing it now. Thank you.
I'd say, like, arrangement-wise, what makes you as an interesting, you know, sort of, like, ensemble and unit together is, like, the fact it's a bit like a breadcrumb trail where you're kind of, like, following it along and you're going this way, and then suddenly, rather than going down the obvious path, it goes into the woods instead, you know, and you just suddenly end up, like, kind of, like, yeah, immersed in something that you didn't anticipate. Does it feel like that for yourselves when you're actually constructing the music? Like, you don't know what you're doing and it just happens? Or is it quite structured?
I can kind of be a dictator sometimes, like, a little bit. As long as you have, like, some kind of objective, or like just a tune, starting out with an idea that you are convinced is like the idea, and then watching your friends kind of like deconstruct that and transform it into something that's alive. I'm not like a missionary or anything, like I'm not trying to, the music is for me, it's about me and it's for me. I feel like you can get a sense of that from the music. I mean, we're all the same. So if I'm making music about myself, I'm making music about everybody. That's the sound bite. That's what I wanted to say. Yeah.
Doesn't make you a white whale. Oh.